Hello, my name is Richard Peña. I'm a professor of film studies at Columbia University, and I'm here at the Quad Cinema in New York City to introduce some films that are going to be presented to you from the Cohen Media Channel. The first group of films I'd like to discuss is a series of films by Benoit Jacquot. Benoit Jacquot is certainly one of France's most respected and in certain ways most prolific filmmakers. Since about the late 1980s, he's produced about a film a year, and he continues to work very much at that clip. Benoit began his career serving as an assistant to the great writer-director Marguerite Duras. They worked together for a number of years, including on India Song, generally seen as Duras's greatest contribution to the cinema. And after that, about the mid-70s, he began to make films on his own. Benoit Jacquot has said that what brought him to the cinema was his love for books and his love for women. And in many ways, his films are really exemplary of these two passions in Benoit's life. First of all, many of his films really are very dependent on their screenplays. You could say that he helped bring back to French cinema a tradition of really well-crafted screenwriting, which had perhaps been a little bit subsumed under the sort of more spontaneous cinema of the French New Wave. He's also worked with and continues to work with many of France's finest actresses, Isabelle Huppert, Isabella Gianni, Isile Lobesco, Judith Goodrich, Dominique Sanda. Many of France's finest actresses have really had their best performances working for Benoit Jacquot, and it seems that they line up to work in his films because he writes such strong, intelligent characters for these women. The first film, chronologically, in this set of Benoit Jacquot films is The Disenchanted from 1989. It's a film that's built around the performance of the actor Judith Goodrich, who really was only 17 at the time. It gives an incredibly well-rounded, very mature performance. In many ways, of the set of films you're going to see by Benoit Jacquot, The Disenchanted is the most experimental of them. That is, it probably has the loosest form of narrative. The other films you'll see have a much more traditional take on narrative with lots of continuity and subplots or whatever. This is really a kind of fragmentary narrative. It's almost moments from the life of a character versus kind of a full story that has a dramatic arc. She's 17, 18, which was about the age of Judith Goodrich at that time, and she's basically facing a series of choices that have been thrust upon her in terms of her romance, in terms of her future, in terms of her relationship to her mother, her relationship to her younger brother. All of these things are, in a sense, decisions she's going to have to make during the course of the film or figure out a way of putting off those decisions. She attacks the role with a tremendous amount of energy and intelligence. One never feels that she's out of a scene. She's always right there, and one can feel, in a sense, that process of decision-making going on. For some viewers, it can be a little confusing because at times it really does seem to skip from character to character. Characters enter into the film, they're there for a while, then they completely disappear. But that was, I think, very much part of Benoit Jacquot's technique in this particular film, to give us this sort of fragmentary vision of the life of this young woman in all its complexity, both in terms of her home life, her romantic life, her relationship with friends, and everything else. The second film we're going to talk about is a film called A Single Girl, which came out in 1995. This was truly the film that moved Benoit Jacquot from being a well-respected French director into an important international talent whose films now would regularly be released, not only in the United States, but really all over the world. It also marked the emergence of a fine young French actor by the name of Virginie Ledoyenne. Virginie Ledoyenne had been revealed the year before that, actually, in 1994, in a film called Cold Water, directed by Olivier Assayas. But it was truly with A Single Girl that she became a kind of international star. Once again, Benoit Jacquot concentrates on the life of a young woman, in this case slightly older than in The Disenchanted. Here Virginie is probably in her mid-20s, whatever, who is juggling romantic relationships, work life, and many other kinds of issues in the course of just mainly a single day. Among the remarkable things about the film is that Benoit Jacquot shoots the film in real time, meaning that there are no spaces between the cuts. Normally, when we see a film, there'll be fade-outs or blackouts or some kind of ellipses so that we know that, well, from the time she entered the building to the time she got to the top floor, something has happened and we don't see that. Not in this film. In this film, we're with her every second. So when there's a cut, it cuts immediately to the continuation of the action that we saw at the end of the previous shot. In many ways, it brings us into the process. We feel every moment as she's working, as she's talking to people, as she's talking to her boyfriend, as she's deciding whether or not she should stay at work. All of these decisions become, in a sense, very visceral for us because we're living through them. We're in a certain way passing the same moments of time that the character is as well. At the end of the film, it jumps a little bit to sort of a period about a year and a half from the first part of the film, but once again, it adopts the same strategy of giving us a moment-by-moment rundown of this character's life. It's really a wonderful film, and again, presents a character that is, I think, intelligent, driven, certainly not perhaps a role model, but a person one feels that is tremendously responsible for herself. This is a woman who is facing some very serious decisions and has to really come to terms with what her future might be. Le Doyen is terrific in the film. There's a fierceness about her that I've always liked, the way in which, you know, she's a very, very beautiful woman, but at the same time, there's a toughness, a kind of core, almost ferocity that comes out in a lot of her performances, and nowhere more than in this particular film. Benoit Jacquot in this film worked with the great cinematographer Caroline Champantier, who's a real tremendous cinematographer, especially with handheld camera. So you feel the camera at all moments, really almost becoming an extension of the character, really almost being part of her body because it moves so naturally with her various movements and trajectories around the spaces that she inhabits. It's really a terrific film, and of all films for Benoit to have as his kind of great calling card internationally, it was tremendous because it really did show what a tremendous talent he was and what an original talent in many ways as well. The last film that we're going to see is a film from the early 2000s, a film called Keep Quiet. It stars Isabelle Huppert, perhaps the greatest contemporary French actress, in, I think, one of her most interesting roles. Huppert has continued to work with Benoit Jacquot over the years. They've created, if not exactly a partnership, a wonderful working relationship. She's, of course, in great demand by many directors, but she seems to work with Benoit every second or third film. They have, obviously, a very good working relationship. And again, Benoit Jacquot has given her, in my mind, some of her finest roles. Here it's an enormously complex film, and in addition to Huppert's great performance, he also gets two very fine performances from two very strong actors, Vincent Landon and Fabrice Luchini. It's a kind of complicated ménage à trois, but not in the kind of typical sense of that term. Isabelle Huppert plays the wife of Fabrice Luchini, who's just gotten out of prison after having been indicted for some white-collar corporate crime, of which it seems he wasn't totally guilty, but in essence accepted the jail sentence so that the investigation wouldn't go further. While he's been away, something has clearly developed between Vincent Landon, Fabrice Luchini's brother, and Isabelle Huppert. All this is revealed very quickly, so I'm not really ruining too much for you in the film. With that kind of knowledge, or with that sense that I wouldn't call knowledge, that inability to openly speak about what this situation is, Benoit Jacquot really gives the film a tremendous amount of force. One feels that every moment that there's going to be an explosion. And yet this is really a film about delayed reaction, the idea of people who are living in this tension, but partially because these are people from an extreme sort of upper class environment, one that Benoit Jacquot, I must say, works very well in. He seems to understand the codes and habits of people in this upper echelon of French society better than any other director. One feels at any moment all of these tensions are just going to burst forth and there's going to be some very dramatic scene. But as you'll see, that dramatic scene perhaps never really comes. In a way, Keep It Quiet is really not only the title of the film, but the motto of the film as well. There are certain things that just aren't spoken about. And these are some of the things that Benoit Jacquot finds in the film. The screenplay was written, like all the screenplays in Benoit Jacquot films, at least partially by him. He's always been, as I mentioned, someone who's very faithful to the idea of constructing a scenario that really becomes the basis, the skeleton for the film. This is, of course, in contrast to an earlier generation of French filmmakers we normally think of as the French New Wave, who very often use what they call plan of action narratives. That is, they had a narrative that they knew what was going to happen, but they allowed events to be filled in as we went along. You never get that sense of improvisation in Benoit Jacquot's films. They're extraordinarily precise. One feels, even in a film like A Single Girl, with the constantly moving, roaming camera, that's still at every moment, whether it's a gesture or a camera move or something changing the environment, all has been meticulously planned out beforehand. Again, just a different approach to cinema. Benoit Jacquot continues to produce films. Again, just about every year there's a new film by him, and he continues to work with many of the finest, especially actresses, in France right now. He's really become an important figure in contemporary cinema, and this series is an excellent opportunity to be introduced to his work and hopefully to be inspired to catch up with many of the other films that he's made. I'm Richard Peña, again for Cohen Media Channel. Thanks for watching, and now enjoy these films.